Hi, I'm Lovenigasri Rajendran from GT22, and I have chosen question 1. And based on question 1, as you can see, we have to discuss about the price of sanitizers sold at a selected few stores in District A during COVID-19 pandemic. Based on the sample data at 0.05 level of sick critical, can we conclude the average price of the sanitizer in District A, which is 10 ringgit and 50 cent? And I have to make my own conclusion using the P approach with the help of Excel. So as you can see, I have also stated the prices and the number of stores at District A. Okay, for the following step, I will start by pressing the search button, and I will click manage in it. Then I'll be able to find this button which shows add in. So once I click that, I will see, find the analysis tool pack out of the 4. Then I shall press OK for it. Then it's much more easier since I'm just going to drag it to get my answer. First I will press data, then data analysis. Then I will just go and find the descriptive statistic and click OK for it as well. And I will just have to put the input range in it and drag as much as which are the selected areas that I want to count in. And I will just press output range, change it to output range to find the outputs, and click it as well, insert it in the cell and just place it up by some also pressing the summary statistic and the confident level of mean. Then finally I'll just click OK, and I'll adjust the column according to the size of the words so that you can clearly see the answers as well. That's it, you can get the median, standard error and all of it just in one click. So based on the Excel that we have done before, we can conclude that the sample mean of column 1 is 10.4286 and the sample standard deviation is 0.7204, and so for the sample size it is 7. Thus the null hypothesis is 10.5, which same goes to the alternative hypothesis. So as we know, based on that we can show that the rejection region will be in a significant level of 0.05 and the critical value of a two-tailed test for the T will be 2.447, and thus it shows the statistic of T will be negative 0.262. Thus we can conclude that the null hypothesis is rejected. Therefore it is not enough evidence to claim the population mean, which is different than RM10.50 at the 0.5 significant level. Hence it's concluded that the average price of the sanitizer in District A is not different than RM10.50, which we can also see in the P value approach. Thank you.
Hello everyone, so my name is Lovenigasri, and today I'd like to show you guys how to do the problem number 3. So this is the question where it shows that at 0.05 level of confidence level, can we make a conclusion that on average the price has not changed? So as you can see, this is the before and after the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay guys, this is how I do it. As you can see, we have to list down from the smallest to largest number for the before and after. And we can know that n equals to 6, so it would be very easy to find mean, sample variance, and also sample standard deviation. This is the answer for the before. Okay, next, as you can see, this is the after, and my answer for mean, sample variance, and also sample the standard deviation is this one. Okay. Next, hypothesis test for a difference in means variance. As you can see, the choice of statistic distribution, I have been using this formula to find the quantity, and then the formula to find the common standard deviation, which is equals to 0.4239. And this is the hypothesis approach, where you can see the null hypothesis is equal to 0, but then alternative hypothesis is not equals to 0. So because of this, not equals to 0, this is two-tailed test. And I'm using test statistic using this formula, and to find it equals to negative 0.954. I'm using the markers of Excel to find it also, and Rosalie's brown hair to find the mean variance very easily for the before and after. Lastly, this is the decision using a p-value and significance level. Thus, there is not sufficient statistical evidence that 95% confidence level is on average, so the price has changed. No, there is not sufficient data telling the price has changed actually. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, hello. So, my name is Nurul, and I live in Amirulsafari. My name is PG. 1911000007. So yeah, my solution. Problem four. As we know, the problem four using the ANOVA. How I know that the problem four using the ANOVA, we can see that this keyword. Okay, there is a significant difference in mean price of three pairs of sanitizer. So obviously we use the ANOVA. How we want to get the alpha? So here is our at 90% of computer level. So yeah, and then the question asks us to use the p-value approach. Okay, p-value approach. So here is the data. How I want to get the alpha? I just minus with 100, so I get to 0.10. So we have to do the statement assumption, which is h null equals to mean 1 equals to mean 2 equals to mean 3. And then the h 1, we used to at least one mean is not equal. You have to reject the h null if the p value is lesser than alpha. So here is my calculation using the Excel. Okay, as you can see, I just copy the data, copy back the data and put it into Excel. So go to the data tab and then choose the data analysis. Okay, click on the ANOVA single factor. For the input range, you select all of this, and then it is grouped by column. So you have to label in the first row, and then the alpha, put with the 0.10. So the output range, just choose anywhere you like, and then click OK. So here's the method or way on how I get the answer using the Excel. Back to the question. So I have interpreted some of the data which is do not reach the hash null, since the p-value is greater than significant level. And then the conclusion for this problem, we do not reach the h null because there is not enough evidence to conclude that there is a significant difference in mean price of the three brands of sanitizer. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ezly in Xmas Latiun, and my matrix number is PG1911002. The business statistic group assignment, we were given 5 questions by our lecturer, and our group has 6 people. We discuss and agree on dividing the question. For problem 5, Alvin and I will be answering it. We already divided our part where I will be answering the question A and B, and Alvin will be answering the question C. Question A, run a regression analysis based on the data in table 4 using Microsoft Office Excel. Based on the output, propose a regression equation that can be used to predict sales by an employee. First, after inputting table 4 data in Microsoft Excel, we need to run a regression analysis. In order to do this, go to the data tab and select data analysis, and then choose regression. Select the Y range like this. This is the predictor variable, also called dependent variable. Then select the X range like this. These are the explanatory variables, also called independent variables. This column must be adjacent to each other. Check labels, click in the output range box and select cell A11, then click OK. We'll then have the regression analysis like this. Create a regression equation. We just need to look at the output we got in the regression analysis. The equation should be like this. Y equals beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus, where beta is the intercept. Go back to the regression analysis and focus on it. Our beta 0 is 21.293, beta 1 is 3.103, beta 2 is 4.698. Once all the value are inserted in the equation, we will then have our regression equation, which is this: sales by an employee equal 21.293 plus 3.103 x1 plus 4.698 x2. For the next question, which is B, we just need to interpret on the coefficient value we have obtained in the regression equation. Pi indicates that a unit increase in x1, xi will increase or decrease the value of y by bi unit, given that the other independent variables remain constant. B1 equals 3.103 indicates that the longer the employee works with the company will increase the sale by an employee by 3.103 as other variables remain constant. B2 equals 4.698 indicates that an increase in the business aptitude test score will be increased the sales by an employee by 4.698, given that the other variables remain constant. So that's all from me, and now I'm going to let Alvin explain about the questions.
Hello, my name is Alvin Erickson Albert, but you can call me Alvin, and my matrix number is PG1911-0117. So just now my friend Ezly has explained about how to solve question A and B. So now I'm going to move to question C, which is: is each independent variable sharing a significant linear relationship with the dependent variable? Verify at 0.05 level of significance. Make your conclusion based on the p-value in the Excel output. Okay, so in this question, we're going to state there's some steps how to do it, from hypothesis until we reach at the conclusion part. Okay, so for this question, step 1, we need to state the hypothesis. So there are two hypotheses, which is the null hypothesis, which is HO, and alternative hypothesis, which is HO. Okay, so the hypotheses are HO, if B1, which is beta 1, equals to 0, there is no significant linear relationship. However, for the alternative hypothesis, which is H1, if B1 does not equal to 0, there is no significant linear relationship. Okay. Step 2, state the decision rule. So, our decision will be, we will reject the null hypothesis, which is HO, if the probability value, or p-value, is less than the alpha value, which is the level of significance, 0.05. Step 3, it's kind of simple, because all we need to do is just go back to our regression analysis and just focus on the p-value. Okay, for x1, the p-value is 0.179. So, we can make a decision where, since the p-value, which is 0.179, is larger than the alpha value, which is 0.05, then we do not reject HO. So, in conclusion, for x1, there is no significant linear relationship between the number of sales made by an employee and how many years that employee has been with the company. For x2, we're going to do the same thing as before, but we're going to focus on x2, which is the how he or she, the employee, scored on business aptitude test. Okay. The hypothesis are, the null hypothesis will be B2 equals to 0, which will be there is no significant linear relationship, or the alternative hypothesis, which is H1. B2 does not equal to 0, which there is a significant linear relationship. Okay. So our decision rule will be as before, which is we will reject HO if the p-value is less than the alpha value, which is 0.05. Okay, so then we need to find the p-value for the x2, which is 0.079. So obviously, so since the p-value is 0.079, which is larger than the alpha value, which is 0.05, then we do not reject HO. So in conclusion, there is no significant linear relationship between the number of sales made by an employee and how he or she, the employee, scored on a business aptitude test. So that's all for question C, problem 5. Thank you so much, Anna. Yeah, thank you.